What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe, hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, I'm going to be mainly focusing on the fundamentals and basics of laser cutting. So here's what to expect. We're going to be doing a little bit on how exactly a laser works, what exactly is a laser design, and what you can get out of a laser, the materials, a touch on safety, and then the tips that I wish I knew right at the start. To give you a little bit of context on where exactly all this laser information comes from, I've been working with lasers for the past 3 to 4 years. I started on a Speedy 360 in a London makerspace, and then I moved on to an SP3000, which is a massive 3 meter by 2 meter laser, 200 watt, incredible beast. And now I'm working on a little Glowforge at home. So big, wide variety of lasers, so I want to really try and condense that as varied as I can so it covers as much information for somebody who's wanting to learn more about lasers and what they can provide. So, what exactly is a laser? How do they come and all that? Keeping it completely very brief, lasers come in two forms, a galvo laser and a laser plotter. This video is all about laser plotters, because I don't really have that much experience with galvo lasers. Now, you don't exactly need to know how a laser is made and how it works, but it's great to know the fundamentals of how it gets from the laser tube over to the material to do a successful cut. In essence, an unfocused laser comes out of the laser tube, which is then reflected by mirrors to the head. In the head, there is a lens which is going to focus your laser to the correct space on the material. Sometimes this is automatic, sometimes this is manual. And then from there, when you have the right combination of speed, power, air assist, and material, you'll have a successful cut. I will be doing a separate video on how I find my settings to get the perfect cut, in my opinion. But what I'm going to say now is start with a low power and go up, as it's the safest way to approach it. Okay, one last little detail you need to know is that the laser cut itself has a width, and it's called a kerf. What this means is that if you cut a 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter cube, and it's 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter on your computer, when you cut it, it's going to be a little bit smaller. Now, not only that, but the kerf is not straight, mainly due to the focal length and the loss of power while cutting through the material. Now, this means that every thickness and every type of material will have a slightly different cut kerf on every single one. I'm going to leave it there because I could literally do an entire video on just laser kerf. Now, on to design. I'm going to keep this super broad, as every single brand out there has its own software and its own hardware and their own quirks. But 90% of the time, the laser design has to be a vector graphic to be correctly read by the software. A vector graphic means that the design is created out of mathematical paths that the software can read relatively easily. I personally use Rhino and Illustrator, but many people use a free program called Inkscape. As to how these designs are going to come out on the laser, it's one of three ways, which is either a vector cut, also known as just a cut, a vector etch, which is also known as a kiss cut or marking, and finally a raster, or also known as an engraving. Using a combination of these three laser processes, you practically have a limitless option of design potential. I'm going to leave that there, as I will be making a few how-to vector graphic design for laser. So make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon so you get notification when those videos are out. Now onto materials, with a touch of safety as well as my tips. Laser cutters are amazing because they have a huge range of materials that can be used with them. There is a small caveat though. Keep in mind that this does not mean everything, and that you are burning and vaporizing the material that you're cutting into. So fumes and material composition play a huge part here. Now, without making this list far too long, you have wood, cardboard, acrylic, paper, foam, fabric, along with marking glass, metal, slate, and ceramic. It truly is amazing the amount of materials a laser can cut. Having said that, it's always a good idea to err on the side of caution and heavily research every new material. Without making this video an hour long, let's take a deeper look at wood, for example. Now, wood covers a huge range of material, from solid wood to MDF to plywood to cork. I'll say it now that 99% of the time, cutting solid wood, you're going to have no problem, as long as you don't go too thick and you have the correct amount of air assist to put out any potential fires. Now, one of my personal favorites is plywood. It's absolutely amazing. Once again, thickness plays a big part, air assist plays a big part, but most importantly is glue composition. What you're looking for here is interior grade glue, not exterior grade, as those are usually epoxy based. So epoxy based glues release nasty fumes, including chlorine, which is both harmful for you and your machine. Plus, they're heat resistant, which means they get a lot hotter and with a much higher risk of catching on fire, and they will char the edges of your workpiece. Usually the best way to tell the difference between interior and exterior glue is taking a close look between the layers of ply. If you see a thin black line, this is epoxy based. And if you can't see anything, it's usually interior grade. Cork, once again, keep in mind the glue. As mentioned, keep an eye on the edge quality. The more charred, the higher concentration of glue content is in the material. And the one that I find quite controversial is MDF, also known as particle board or draft board. I personally will never cut MDF or anything with MDF on my laser ever again. I've had more than my fair share of it, and if you really think about it, all you're really cutting is glue and dust. Which, as I've said, glue is not exactly your best friend when it comes to lasers. Plus, due to the high glue concentration, it has an incredible amount of formaldehyde in it. Even the low formaldehyde emission MDF is graded when it is in a standstill in a room, not when it is being vaporized by a laser. In fact, I've cut so much MDF in the past that I now have a formaldehyde intolerance, an allergy to formaldehyde. So if you yourself cut MDF, you're going to see there's this large buildup of this brown sticky substance on your cutting bed. That there is primarily formaldehyde. If I get anywhere close to that stuff, even if I'm wearing gloves, I come up in rashes all over. Now, there are not that many scientific studies on the long-term effects of formaldehyde, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. Additionally, that brown sticky stuff is very flammable, and I've actually had two laser fires of just that igniting. Now, onto my top laser safety and getting started tips. Do lots of tests. Learn the limitations and strengths of your laser. Never leave your laser unattended. Even if you've done that job a million times, always have some sort of eye on it. If at any point any ignition happens due to the air assist and the high volume of air in there, it's going to go bad and fast. I think it goes without saying of keeping things clean. A clean machine is a faster machine and a safer machine. And as my final one, master your kerf. Learning the kerf of your laser, which can be different depending on the axis that it's cutting on, will open doors to extreme precision for you. So those are the fundamentals and basics of laser cutting, along with tips that I wish I knew right at the start. There's going to be a lot more coming from me, along with design, tips, and testing out different things for you guys. So make sure you check down in the description for the videos and the playlist, as well as the card and the video up here right now. If you enjoy what I'm doing here and want to support the channel, I have this laser cutting shirt. It's one of my favorite shirts that I've had for quite a while. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.